How have you been?
I'm feeling better.
Are you ready to tell them your story?
My story? We'll see.
No one wants their life to be thrown into chaos. That is why a lot of people keep that threat under control. But I was drawn to all the wrong things. I was settled into nothingness, a kind of non-being, and I accepted it. I don't want to see anyone. I didn't want to be interesting at all. What I really wanted was only a soft, hazy space to live in and to be left alone. I am fine by my own, but as much as I hate to admit it,
it was starting to get difficult.
I dislike school. There's this range of academic pressure derived from a need for perfection, worry of grades, parental pressure, competition. Wait, guys.
What's wrong? What did I even do to you?
Failure ka sa tong room niya. Failure ka sa tanan aspects. Diba?
Oh, failure sa tanan. Grabe kayo.
Sa love life, sa biga-biga, ang gawin mo giyon.
Bukat yung bag ni mo sa suit, di ba? Kaya suit ni brong bag. Bubukay ka.
Sa'yo mo nagamitan?
Oh, napay mong papinis. Kasi gamit ani. Masunis sa utok. Dabay niya eh.
Bukan si gingo ni madam. Dapat magminaw ka niya. Di ka sige kagsuwat.
Ito.
Gets mo, girl?
Are you done insulting me?
Yes.
Some may not understand this. They just don't understand how desperate I am to have someone say, "I love you," and they support you because you're wonderful just the way you are. they don't understand that it's been so long since anyone has told me that. But then again, how could they? They're just not me. Is there no way out of the mind?
If you could describe your life in one word, what would it be?
What would it be? Was lonely because I just want to be alone. I mean, it feels good, really, if you're alone. Even though for other people, being lonely is not right, but it feels good being alone.
What caused you to change?
Pardon?
Matthew 6:33. Well, as far as I can tell, no one's really here.
As far as I can tell, you just don't approach the people you don't know.
Forget it.
That's disrespectful, you know.
What is?
Why don't you go inside?
For what reason?
For whatever reasons, one goes to church.
Why? What?
To see God? To talk to God? Listen, miss, I appreciate what you're doing right now.
But, no thanks.
Here.
What? What is it? Don't touch me!
You need to try. Do yourself a favor. Don't shut him out of your life. You need him more than anything else.
Seek him.
What?
He never listens. And he never will.
You regularly hear people say, "My prayer was answered." He doesn't just answer prayer with a yes. Sometimes he says no, often he says wait.
To wait is to resign myself to the miracle.
No, that's not it.
If pain must come, it may come quickly.
Because I have a life to live and my time is running.
If he makes a choice, may he make it now. Because by then, either I will wait for him or forget him.
No! You need to change and try harder. Nothing in your life will do if you continue this mentality. Keep that in mind. Praying is not asking, it is the longing of the soul. It is the daily admission of one's weakness.
Are you quoting Gandhi now?
You need him. You need God.
Keep that in mind.
Karin.
What caused such disbelief?
Well, I've always believed God existed because I know people need him, people ask him for wishes, prayers, but I don't know. I thought it's different. So, what do you believe in? Talking about the breakup, then. Well, I saw him the other day.
Really? So?
Nothing is really worse than seeing them together. And knowing that I will never have to see him again.
Bruce was such a...
Do you want advice for my old friend? Enlighten me.
After a relationship and build a bridge,
get over it and burn that bridge so you won't be tempted to cross it. But it's just so hard not being able to see that person again. It's just so hard not being able to talk to someone you used to talk to every day. I don't know, Pat. Still hurts. I don't know, Pat. It still hurts. Well, now that we're through, I have realized that we're not meant for each other. Pat, you're crossing the line.
Some people think that holding on makes you stronger.
But
you have to let her go.
It's different in your case, Pat.
She was my best friend.
Leave.
You have to remove this dream in your heart, Karina. Surely I'm not guilty at
all. How could you say that? Of course, it's always the cliches that cause the trouble. Although I can't. She's all that I have. How did you lose her? Oh, how did I lose her? She was very sick. Very, very sick, actually. She's been suffering for that for a long time. And after that, I blame God for it. Well, you see, it's funny because right after she died, a question formed in my mind.
If there's one God, why are there more than 4,000 religions? There's a lot of bad news on TV every single day. A lot of people suffer. The world is in chaos. Where are these gods in times of need? How does one know when God has been answering their prayers? Does He answer prayers? If yes, then why didn't He answer mine?
Won't she light a lamp and score the house, looking in every nook and cranny until she finds it?
And when she finds it, can be sure she'll call her friends and neighbors. Celebrate me! I found my lost coin.
What are you talking about? What kind of parable is that? What are you trying to say to me?
Kind of celebration God's angels throw every time one soul turns to God.
Hey, it's a wonderful parable.
truth is, no one understands.
No one seeks their God. God looks down at heaven and all mankind to see if there are any
who seeks God, who understands. But none do. All have turned away.
They have together become worthless. There is no one who does good.
Not even one.
How am I supposed to understand this?
Can you answer me?
You need to surrender yourself to God.
What God? Does your God listen to you? Because I have. I am one with Him now.
Now tell me. Does your God listen to you? He doesn't even listen to me. There's no God.
Not at all.
I once was lost, and now I am found.
And you will be too, Karim. It was from then on, I understood.
What have you understood?
I don't know. I was once hopelessly lost and take the supernatural work of God to find me. Because I was so blind. Yeah, I was really blind and groping in the dark for one time.
It took a Holy Spirit to awaken me to the grace of God. But I never found God. He found me.
The Holy Spirit? Not the Holy Spirit. Ah, Holy Spirit. You have never met my sister, have you?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Let me...
Okay.
This is her. She is Nessa. Before she left, she told me something that I cannot forget.
What is it?
She told me not to grieve for her loss. And that she may be lost, but she's found. And also, my little sister gave me something. A rosary. You see how sweet my little sister is. Ate loves you very much, Dexa.
Turmoil life brought me down many hard paths from which I never fully recovered until I met Jesus Christ. I could see that I was ending up in the wrong place, and I did not know how to get out of it. I had not been faithful to what was in my heart. I knew I was missing something. Later did I know that I was missing Christ.
Lord,